Hello, I'm Ed Brorain, an application specialist for Agilent Technologies Systems Product Division. And today I'll talk about how to test the line regulation of a DC voltage regulator. This testing is made quick and easy using an N6782 source measure module for functional testing. This device can source and sink current, so it performs as both a source and electronic load for testing voltage regulators and other similar components. Together with the N6705B DC power analyzer mainframe and 14585B software, this forms a platform for testing power components. Here I wired up a 3-pin voltage regulator, and it's set up for 10 volts output. And I have the input side of the voltage regulator connected to channel 1 of our DC power analyzer mainframe. And I have the output connected to channel 2 of the DC power analyzer. The DC power analyzer has two N6782 source measure modules to provide both power and loading for testing the load line regulation of the voltage regulator. Here in my diagram, I have both the output voltage of the regulator and input voltage of the regulator displayed. And line regulation is the change in output voltage in response to the change in input voltage of the regulator. Here we have the regulator connected to the N6705B DC power analyzer. Again, channel 1, we have one module providing bias to the device under test, and we have the second N6782 acting as an electronic load to load the output of the voltage regulator. And we'll use the first source to provide a voltage square wave to the input of the voltage regulator, and we'll use the second module as a load, and it'll be measuring the output voltage of the regulator. These modules have built-in high-speed digitizing readback for voltage and current, making it easy to capture voltage and current waveforms of the device under test. Here we have the 14585A control and analysis software user interface, which is being used to control the N6705 DC power analyzer. It's a quick and easy way to set up and display the results from the power analyzer, although everything you see here in the software can be done directly on the front panel of the DC power analyzer as well. The first thing we need to do is set up the DC bias conditions for our sourcing and loading for the device under test. And to do that, I first need to go over on the right of our software and click on our instrument control panel to bring up the settings and controls for the modules. First, I'm going to do is set up output 1. So let me click on output 1, and then I'm going to set its voltage and current parameters. And here it's set to be a 2-quadrant DC power supply. We have set it for voltage priority because we want a voltage source, and we've set it up for 13 volts output. That's our minimum input line voltage for the regulator as the low line condition. Now we want to set up output 2. So let me select output 2, and here now we have our source conditions. Output 2 is acting as an electronic load. So again, here we've selected CC load conditions. As you can see, we have a list of pre-configured conditions for quickly and easily setting up the particular operation for the particular module we're using. We've set it up for minus 50 milliamps of drain current. You can see it's negative current because it's in a loading operation. So we're now completed setting up our steady state biasing conditions. We now need to set up our arbitrary waveform conditions to be able to pulse the line voltage high and low. For that, we have our ARB function, and I can go up here and click on the ARB screen tab to bring up the ARB settings. What we need to do is apply a voltage square wave to the input one voltage. So going down to the bottom of the screen here, I have selected a sequence being applied to input one voltage. And as you can see, I'm using a square waveform, and the square waveform is stepping from 13 volts up to 18 volts, 18 volts representing the high line condition. And I'm using a 1 hertz frequency. That's to provide plenty of steady state at each level to be able to get a good DC reading on the line regulation. So now we've completed setting up our ARB function. I need to set up my measurement conditions. And for that, I'm going to use the data logger for capturing and displaying the results. So I'm going to click on my data logger selecting screen button. And now we are in data logging display mode. And what I want to do is capture input voltage and output voltage. So I've selected V1 input voltage and V2 the output voltage to capture for line regulation testing. I've set up for 200 milliseconds per division. We're using a 1 hertz signal. And I've set up my other acquisition parameters accordingly. I'm triggering on the ARB run button in order to capture the waveform. So all they need to do is first start the data logger by clicking on the start button down here in the bottom lower corner. And then I need to start up the ARB function, and that'll start the capture. And so you can see I have captured up here the yellow trace, the input voltage, the line condition going from a low line condition of 13 volts up to a high line condition of 18 volts. And below it, the green trace is the output voltage response, the line regulation of the line of voltage regulator. Here is the voltage for the low line condition, and here is the voltage for the high line condition. And to be able to measure that, I'll use my markers, which I have up on the ends of the graph. And let me first move them to a portion of the curve that has high line voltage being applied. And so down in the numerical results, I find I have an average voltage on the output of 10.033 volts, roughly. Now let me move the markers to a low line condition. And now I find down here, again in the numerical results, I now have about 10.028 volts. So I'm seeing about 5 millivolts of line regulation, which is roughly about 0.05% of the output of a 10-volt regulator, which is very typical of a linear regulator performance. And so this is a way you can test the line regulation of a voltage regulator, easily accomplished using the N6782 DC source measure module for functional test, together with the N6705B DC power analyzer and 14585A software. Thank you.